Good morning, students. In continuation of our topic, radioactivity, today we want to look at activity, or we call it count rate, and also half-life of radioactive substance. Our objectives for today will be instruments used to detect radioactive radiations, structure and operation of Biga-Muller's tube, activity or count rate, and then half-life of radioactive substances. Instruments used to detect radioactive radiations. There are several instruments used to detect radioactive radiation. Here we just listed three. The first is the Biga-Muller's tube, which is the most common instrument. It works by ionization of gas. Then we have the diffusion cloud chamber. Also, it works by ionization of gas. And then we have the scintillation chamber. Here is a picture of the Biga-Muller's tube. Now, this tube contains argon inside. The gas called argon is inside this tube. Now, this picture is the picture of the rate meter. The rate meter is connected to the tube here. This is the Biga-Muller's tube. This is the rate meter. Now, radiation of alpha, beta, or gamma enters this tube from this end and ionizes the argon gas that is here. And when ionization takes place, ionization, the splitting of the gas molecules into ions and electrons. Now, when it takes place, ions and electrons are accelerated to the electrodes of this tube. And when they are accelerated there, the count rate counts what has happened in the tube, the ionization that goes on the tube. This count rate, or the count meter, or we'll say the rate meter, counts it as much as possible. Activity, count rate. By definition, see, this is the average number of disintegration of atoms of a given sample of radioactive substance. If you are given a radioactive substance, there are several atoms in the radioactive substance that disintegrate. The disintegration occurs randomly. You cannot predict which atom will disintegrate. Now, as disintegration occurs like that, the average number that disintegrates is what we call activity, or we call it the count rate. We say it varies irregularly because it occurs randomly, and then it decreases as number of atoms disintegrate. The graph of activity against time. Okay. This is the graph of activity against time. As the activity decreases, it decreases with time, so it's like this. Now, it is not a straight line graph because it's actually a random process. Then, half-life. We say this is the average time it will take half of the atoms in a given radioactive sample to decay. We say this is different for different radioactive samples. This can be determined from the decay curve of the radioactive sample. Let me quickly speak on this half-life. Since it is difficult to determine the exact atom that is going to disintegrate, now, we are given a sample of radioactive substance. Now, the time it will take for half of that sample to disintegrate is what we call the half-life of that sample. We can determine the half-life of any sample from this graph here. Now, here we have 8,000. 8,000, this is the initial sample given to you. Now, the time it will take for it to go to half its original size, that is 500. Here, the time it takes is what we call our T1. So this is the half-life. From 0 to this T1, we call it half-life. Now, the time it takes for it to move from 500 to 250 is also the other half-life from year to year. Okay. I've posted notes on radioactivity, on count rate, and half-life in your Google class. So I want you to take time, go through the notes, the calculations you need, I will explain better next time. Thank you very much.